Hey everyone, it's Daphne from Scrap and Create, and I'm here to share with you today my latest completion, which is Cottage Life, one of Graphic 45's latest releases. So I had earlier sent out sort of a sneak peek of the cover, so some of you have seen this, but I'll go over it pretty briefly. I've got the Graphic 45 Ivory Flowers and the Precious Pink, and then over here and here and a little bit over here are the 49 and Market flowers. All of the materials used in this project, as usual, will be listed under the description of the video. And the first thing you're going to see is the material list, and that'll be followed by the cut list. Right here, I featured one of the chipboard pieces, a couple of pieces of chipboard here, here, and here, and then a little one tucked in over here. This is one of the die cuts from the package. This is also a die cut. This is fussy cut from the signature page. So is this and this. This is the corners that I used on the projects. And if you buy your bundles from us, you'll get some coordinating charms and filigree corners to go with it. This is also cut from the signature page. And then I did something simple on the spine. I'm probably gonna add some more stuff to that. I just don't know what yet. And there's the back. This was one of my favorite pages. So I did a partially wrapped spine. Okay, so that's our cover. On the inside, I made a very large pocket with a nice sized, I think it's 6x8 insert. So you can store a lot of in this pocket. And then what I like to do is get an envelope and then place all my remaining journaling cards and little bits and pieces that I want to use to decorate my pages as I lay in my photos. So having this on behind the front cover and on the front side of the back cover, it's a great place to store those elements. This is one of the ephemera cards, and I've got a piece of chipboard here. This is a sticker, and this was a cut apart from the 8x8 collection. I've got a Graphic 45 tag here, and I split the pattern here. I just thought it made it really pretty. This is also a cut apart. And then we've got a nice large photo mat that I was able to completely cover on one side, and I do have enough paper to cover the back side, so I'm probably going to come back and do that, but I didn't do it for this walkthrough. Okay, and then here we're onto page two. So page two features a card fold and then a tri-fold. These are from the die cut pack. So is this, and then so are these down here. Over here, I've got two matching pockets with two matching tags, and then it turns out I had that left over from the Let It Be, and I just thought it was so pretty I wanted to use it, and a flower. I've got a die cut here and here to add some visual interest to this page. And then another full photo mat. This is page four and five. So these open away from each other, which I think is kind of nice. Both of these, I'll take one of my tags from here. This has an insert inside. And then this is a tuck spot here. And the same thing here. I've got a little die cut here on the top as a tab. So both of these slide out so you can put a photo on either side. And then the pieces that I added as design elements are open-ended so that you can tuck your photos slightly behind it. And then we've got even more photo space here, and each one has a nice pocket here. So these are relatively small inserts, but you could have a full page insert if you wanted. And I think these are both 4x6 inserts. But like I said, if I turn it this way, you can see they could be substantially larger. So you can have very large photos here. And then another large photo mat. And then we've got two more tags here. I didn't decorate the pockets because I added a little more bling to the tags. So I've got a chipboard element as well as charm, and that is also the case here. Okay, now on this, it's the same elements as on page two, but instead of being vertical, I changed it to horizontal. So I've got a bifold card here and then a trifold card here. And in retrospect, I probably would have done page 2 and 7 the same. I like the way this all flows together. And this is open-ended as well. And another nice large photo mat. And that leads us to our last final page, which is page 8. And I just did some layering. So this is actually fussy cut from the collection. This is a nice large photo mat. This is open-ended so that you can put a photo here and tuck it slightly behind the label. Over here is an ephemera card that I created a tuck spot for an additional tag in. This tag is journal side up. Lots of room for photos. And then as in the front, I've got this nice deep large pocket here in the back to add lots of photos. This is also an excellent place to store any of the elements that you want to save and use when you're actually putting your photos into your album. So that's it, Cottage Life. I hope you guys enjoyed. I really liked working with this paper more than I thought I would. I thought it was gonna be a little bit too pink for me, but I tried to downplay some of the pink and pull out more of the blue, and I think I was relatively successful. So I'd love to hear your comments on this. As always, this is Daphne from Scrap and Create, and I'll be back soon.